Hello, it's myself, Jamie of GEOSynths, and I'm back with my top 10 tips. Okay, so last time we did oscillator blending, which is very important, actually. You know, you want to create that total wave shape rather than looking at each oscillator on its own. This time, we're going to move on to envelopes. Now, envelopes aren't exactly the sexiest of topics when it comes to synthesizers. It's probably one of the most boring aspects that, you know, when you think about it, you get your oscillators and then you start doing your amp and then you do your filter shape as well. And you probably do them the same or very similar from each other. And then just so you could just jump onto the cutoff and the resonance and make it all nice and juicy. I get it. But for me, envelopes are probably the most important aspect of a synthesizer because it denotes the time of the sound. It denotes the levels and the shape. Sometimes it can be a little bit difficult to get your head around them as well. Same as things like LFOs, modulations and so on, but we'll get to those in future videos. But the best way to kind of think of it is either voltage is going through the synthesizer, or you could even think of things like, water hitting a dam. Because at the moment, when you press a key on a keyboard, you'll think you're starting the sound. But the best way to think about it is that the sound is water, and it's being held back by a gate. Now, when you push a key, it's opening that gate, so all that water can flood out. So the whole point of using an envelope is that you control that strength of water over a period of time at different levels. That's probably one way to think about it. You know, so like I say, you can think about it in terms of voltages. So we're here with the world of quantum, and I've got just the oscillators set up at the moment, which is using a wavetable, it's using a sample, and it's using one of the waveforms. So, but there's no envelopes on there, there's no filtering, nothing like that at the moment. So when it comes to the envelopes, of course, yeah, it's not the sexiest of subjects. And trying to get your head around them and what it's doing to the sound over time can sometimes be a little bit difficult. And because it's AUDSR and you've got multiple ones of those, you'll have at least probably two of those on a half-decent synthesizer. Some synths you may have another envelope or four or loads of them like this thing does. And you probably look at them, ADSR, and treat them the same way for the amp and for the filter and probably even set them very similar to each other. But I really see the envelopes has been very different from each other when it comes to the amp and when it comes to the filter, and as well as using it as a source for modulation. So going back to what I was saying about water, right now, with it turned down, I hit a key, but there's no water coming through, there's no sound coming through because the attack is at zero. So we bring it up halfway, and you can see that it gradually fades in. So it's like, you know, using this dam analogy again, instead of the gate being lifted up straight away, it's slowly brought up. But of course, with that, it's brought up over time. So you have like just a little section here. Now, when it comes to the decay stage, turn down the attack, bring up the decay. It's like a mirror image of the attack, really. And then when you bring them together, put them at 50% each. So again, using the analogy of like a gate holding back water on a dam, using the attack and decay is just like how quickly you pull up that gate to allow the water to flow. You pull it up quickly, you get a short attack or short decay. You pull it up slowly, then you get a longer one. And that's probably one way to kind of think about that. So I see attack and decay as the same thing, just mirror images of each other. So sustain doesn't deal with time, it deals with level. So after it's gone through the attack and the decay stages, it will hit a certain level and just stay there as long as that key is pressed. So using the analogy again, you bring up the gate, you slowly bring it up to let more water flow over time, you bring it down to close it down over time, but then you leave it open just a little amount so a steady amount of water can flow. So in this case, a steady amount of volume can flow. And when it comes to the release, it's similar to the decay, but it is only triggered once you release that key. See, it's just holding right in that position. Let go now. And of course, as I said, it's time-based, so the longer or more voltage going through, okay, so that's a bit of a overview of the ADSR. You know, I treat them, in my mind, I think of it as AD in brackets, sustain on its own as just level, and release on its own. So at the moment, we're just dealing with the volume, and I do treat the volume and the filter envelopes very differently from each other. I'd say most of my shaping and tone over time is done with the filter envelope. The shapes I use for the volume envelope are very basic, really, because a lot of the carving out you can do with a filter envelope. And the best thing is just to show you, really. So when it comes to making something like a pad, you probably think, oh, it needs a really slow attack. Which, yeah, you know, it sounds nice. But the problem with that sometimes is when you want to change chord, because it has to go through that cycle again. And if it's going to a beat or something like that, it can sometimes get the feeling that it's dragging behind. Maybe not feeling, but you know what I mean. It's dragging behind the beat. So a lot of the time when I'm making sounds, whether it's a pad or a lead, the amp envelope is probably very similar to each other, and I do all the carving out with a filter envelope. So let's just have a brief example of that. So here we've got the amp envelope, and it's going very slowly. We're making a pad, say. But as you can see here, and also here, is when you change chord, there's like a dropout. Before it builds up to a decent level. So you may think, oh, well, what I'll do, I'll just bring down the attack a bit. Sure, you could do that, but you may think, well, it's not the right amount of length. I still want it quite slow. Now, this is where I tend to make, say, a pad quite... with a bit of the attack knocked off. And the decay. Well, in fact, you know what? I'll probably just have the sustain up full. So you think, well, it's not a very slow sound, is it? How are you going to make a pad out of that? I mean, yeah, it's a bit pad-like, but I want something that's very slow. Well, what I tend to do is, rather than just bringing up the attack of the volume, I actually use the filter envelope to create that impression of a slow attack. Okay, so what I'm going to do is turn the cutoff all the way down. I'm going to go to the envelope amount and bring that up full. All the controls, the ADSR for the filter are down. So you play it and there's nothing. We bring up the filter attack. So it's going from dark to bright. So we've still, turn that just the staying up. We just listen now to the amp envelope. We've still got a kind of short attack and release. In fact, the release is clamped down by the filter. So we've still got a short attack. But if we want to get the impression of a long attack or a slow attack, then we use the filter. So that's going to, because of the settings we've got at the moment, we've got the cutoff all the way down, we've got the envelope amount for the filter up full, so we're going through the maximum amount possible. Think of these as voltage. And the more you bring up, there's more voltage going through, or like the water I was saying before. So we've still got a short attack for the amp envelope, but we're using the filter envelope for the shape as well as the tone. And it'd be the same if we just use the decay, so it'll start off, as well as time, it's also affecting the brightness. So put them both at 50%. So there's a bit of a bloom there, quite a lot of it. So I want it to go on a little bit longer. And what I tend to do for pads, I use the attack probably about, I've got it about 1 o'clock at the moment, and then say 3 o'clock for the decay. So the decay stage is held a little bit longer. On some synths, as well as attack and decay, you'll have a hold. So the hold is, it will hold for a certain amount of time at the decay stage before it starts to fall down. So we've got the slow attack and then a very slow decay. What I sometimes do, or majority of the time, you just let it go through the stage of attack. And then the decay. We'll let it go all the way to the bottom. Now with the keys held down still, just bring up the sustain. Find the level that you want. But I'll probably just bring down that decay a bit because it is a bit too long. So that's a nice sound, isn't it? Of course, we haven't done the release stage yet, even though when we set up the amp envelope, we added quite a lot of release. So what's happening here? Release is turned to zero. So as soon as we let go of that key, it's just clamping down on the sound. So it's like someone getting the cutoff and just turning it right off. So now we just need to bring that up. And sometimes if you get clicks when you're making a sound, check the release of the filter envelope. Now, of course, when it comes to release of a sound, if you have it too long and you play the next chord, then you get double the notes, really. So you could find that you're getting note stealing going on. Thank you. So what's happening here, what we set up was the cutoff all the way down. So you can see the cutoff is all the way down. The envelope amount is up full. So it's going through the stages of the ADSR or AD level and the release stage. And it's going from the minimum to the maximum that it can. So maybe you don't want it to be as much as that. So you may think, well, all I need to do now is just change the envelope stages and get the sound that I want. Well, what I tend to do is then the control for the envelope amount and the cutoff are, in my mind, linked. I kind of use the cutoff as just a bit of a sweetener or, you know, a bit of seasoning. It's a bit of salt and pepper at the end. I don't just go straight to it. So it's going through all those stages from minimum to maximum. Say we wanted just a bit more of a warmer pad so it doesn't go as much as that. What we need to do then is just bring down the envelope amount. Say we've got it at, say, 2 o'clock. It'll be darker. So now this is where we bring up the cutoff. Maybe bring it up a bit more. Maybe if you wanted just a pad, you could put the envelope amount on zero. And it doesn't matter at all about the stages of the ADSR because they won't be affecting it. The envelope amount is, you know, it's essentially how much voltage is going to go through these. And set at zero, I mean, you could have the most wackiest shape on here as much as you like, but without any envelope amount for the filter, it's not going to do anything. So you can just bring up the cutoff and this will go through. It'll just be like a sustain. And we bring up the envelope amount and then it's going to go through these stages. Of course, depending on your settings, like I said, you can get the impression of a slow attack, even though for the amp, we've got a fairly short one. So you've dialed in your sound now, and all you need to do for taste, really, is just mess with the envelope amount and then cut off, and that's it. But this way, because you are using the envelope for the shape of the sound, when you change chord, you can have the sound continuing instead of with the amp where it'll just disappear. You're using darkness to brightness, similar to a low volume to a high volume. You're using it in a similar way. So you can see now, here's the stages. Now, some synthesizers have other parameters, like we've got attack and decay, but then we can have a delay stage. So the envelope won't start straight away. So hopefully you found that quite useful. It's a bit of an overview, a quick one really, for the envelopes. Next video, we'll probably go into a bit more detail of the envelopes and using them in practice to make sound. So things like using an envelope for modulation, some kind of effect over time, whether it would be bringing in an oscillator over time or some kind of effect or whatever. So thanks very much for watching. Remember to subscribe and tap the bell. And of course, check me out over at Patreon. Your support really helps, especially when it comes to doing these videos and the live stream and so on. So thanks very much for your support, and I'll see you next time.